Hey guys, Doug here at Trigger King, here with John Arnold. John, he runs with us in Trigger King, he has for years, but he's actually hosting the, putting on the event here at Vinyl Images here in Fenton. Also, he does the JB graphics, a lot of the vinyl wraps, the graphics you see on our trucks. I know in the Taurus video, we showed some of the graphics, but John does a bunch of the replica stuff where he helps guys replicate stuff. John, I guess you want to talk about the process here and what we've got in front of us. Because you also race. You don't. Yeah. You also race
they,
the monster.
They get beat on. No, I started out with, I couldn't find people to do graphics for me. I couldn't find them to do correct graphics. And you were limited to what you could get. I know several other companies have stepped up, but I really took it personal. Like, I want to build the best graphics I can for my customers to replicate what they want. Mm-hmm. My wife stepped on board. We went and bought some machines and started getting going. I'm still limited as a home operation.
Sure.
I can only do so much. But
it's tough to recreate some of these old graphics too.
It is.
There weren't vector files in '89 or '80. Well, maybe there were. I don't know. But it's tough to find them.
A lot of what I do is pulling from pictures, old pictures from customers. We're finding pictures online. I'm trying to Photoshop them together and make them correct. And there's tons of hours a lot of times in some graphics because there's really bad images out there that I'm just trying to put together. And when I don't release my graphics until the customer approves, I approve, and we think they're high enough quality to go on our trucks. And it's really hard to replicate to a 10th scale from a full size because, you know, the image quality at that.
I know it can help some with some of the big trucks when they get wraps. I know sometimes they release files to people, and that's nice when they
it's always good if you want to get material for your truck is a call or email or Facebook message or whatever the person actually owns a truck is. So most of the time they'll send you to the person who designed their logos.
Yep.
And then you can send the art over to me and we can get rolling. These two trucks in particular, I wanted to step off into wraps. I really wanted to do something cool. I saw this truck was in a country video promo and I was like, I want to do this.
For Firestone, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to do it really bad. I really liked the looks of it. And this truck, actually, my good buddy Joe, which we'll introduce here in a second.
Yeah, we'll bring
that's actually his personal truck. He drives, but it's maybe not as big. It's not a monster truck, but it's pretty tall.
I don't know. It's a pretty damn big truck.
It's a pretty damn big truck. So I wanted to do chrome wrap. You don't see too many of them, and chrome's a little bit harder to wrap, but I think I have the right team together now with the people I work with, especially with Joe Duber from Vinyl Images. I can't go wrong. Joe actually wraps Bigfoot. I guess I'll let Joe talk about it. So we'll bring
Let's bring Joe in here. Joe, if you want to step in.
How you doing?
Good, sir. How are you?
No complaints.
Joe?
So, a little bit about us is we started a family-owned and operated business 15 years ago. Started in a small shop, and then now we're up to 15.5, and we're looking to expand this year as well. What John said about getting the graphics from the right customers, ask permission. It's so much easier to do that than to do it and then have a lawyer call you or something like that.
I've been in trouble for that, I can say. Yeah. You are better off to ask for the most part.
It's so simple. And a lot of these guys, Bigfoot's a great example where we just called. They said, do it. We're having fun. We're just a bunch of kids having fun. So it's,
for those of you that don't know, so obviously they do RC stuff and other things, but you can see as I've edited in, Joe and Vinyl Images wraps everything. I mean, pretty much everything they've done or they do. As it pertains to this, they do wraps for the Bigfoot trucks. I know they've worked with the Nelkies,
yes.
Tailgater, Big Dog, and some other guys too. So they do the full-scale stuff, and they do fantastic work. You guys should see this facility. It's really cool that they've been allowing us to do the RC stuff.
Sure. Yeah.
Thank you guys for
our pleasure for
letting us do that. And I think it's cool that more and more full-scale places now are letting the RC monster trucks into them. It seems like if you deal with full-scale monster trucks, we have to eventually invade your place at some point. Yeah. Whether it's Gravedigger on the East Coast, I haven't seen anything at the Felt Shop yet, but I'd imagine at some point that might happen.
Sure.
But pretty much everywhere else, Dan Patrick, you know, Samson, they do their thing they did for years. Bigfoot, they allowed us. And now we're at Vinyl Images.
Yeah.
Why not? Gateway Classic Mustang as well.
We have run a Gateway Classic Mustang, yeah.
Yeah, so. Yeah. Anyways, I'll put the links in the video here, guys, to JB Graphics, Vinyl Images. If you ever need anything, you enjoy what we do, check them out, please. I know that Joe can ship things.
Yes.
They ship
big,
graphics,
small,
too.
It does not matter.
Yes, you can bring your vehicle in here in Fenton, Missouri, but they can ship whatever.
Yeah.
And I know John ships, you know, to everywhere as well, so. Wanted to give them a thanks. That is how we do a lot of the graphics. Yes, we do paint. Some guys do paint, of course. But for a lot of the guys, it's just cheaper, more cost-effective, and easier to replicate.
Yes.
That's the big thing. When we destroy these trucks, we can replicate the vinyl much easier than we can to paint. So, and that's why the full scale guys do it as well. It's cheaper. So,
thank you guys very much.
Thanks, Doug. Appreciate it so much.
Appreciate it.
Thank you guys, and we will see you next time.